robot feeds on steel, aluminum, and the dreams of its competitors. It's Pangolin!
Weighing 206 pounds, Pangolin rides on six industrial cart wheels and features a unibody welded aluminum frame. And the nose isn't just a wedge. Oh no! It's a flipping device that will toss its opponents like insects.
And Pangolin's owner is Mike Atkins. Mike saw Robotica as a great way to bond with his son, Brett. Together, they built Pangolin. And win or lose, Mike knows he and Brett will have learned something about sportsmanship. Together.
We're Team Pangolin, Robot Pangolin, the newcomers on the block. We're here to make a name for ourselves.
And his opponent, rising up from the depths of the abyss, this monster-sized robot is in 20,000 leagues of its own. It's Nemo's Nexus.
This pyramid-shaped robot reaches the max dimensions allowable, 209 pounds heavy and 4 feet in each direction. Two drive wheels get their juice from 24-volt motors with a third wheel on the swivel caster. And this bot can really make you flip for it, with not one, but two pneumatic scoops aimed in different directions to fend off any angle of attack.
And the captain of this ship is Andy Chen. Andy is the ultimate tinkerer. From the family sedan to an old radio he picked up at a garage sale, Andy can't leave well enough alone. He got the inspiration for Nemo's Nemesis from Jules Verne's 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. And tonight he's going to see if he can take his tinkered creation to the finals.
It's been said it takes three people to make an idiot. Well, we've got four people on our team, so Nemo's Nemesis has got a great chance.
Ah, yes, once again, it's time for the duel. Here we go! Pangolin's up first! Here's the Pangolin came through the cans! He's into the first turn. Nemo's Nemesis motors into his wall of cans too. He's having trouble pushing it aside with that white body design on it. Pangolin wasting no time. Head through the bricks, gonna get another run at the debris here. Nemo pushes those cans into the corner, and now Pangolin hits the blocks! Oh, he's got a lot of debris in front of him now. Mike is trying to fight through it there. Nemo's Nemesis around the first turn, having steering trouble with the bricks.
I bet the combination of having too little steering in that wide frame makes it very difficult to negotiate this trap. The slightest miscalculation puts it right into the wall.
Nemo's Nemesis is trying to straighten out. Pushed a ton of debris there. Pangolin is still struggling through the blocks. Here's the Pangolin cam. Gets a brick on his head, but that's it.
I bet Pangolin has an ineffective wedge design. It doesn't keep debris from getting under his tires, nor does it push it to the side.
Nemo's Nemesis, another unusual wedge design. Andy's robot is carrying every last brick into that wall of blocks. And Pangolin is finally at the halfway point, and it looks like Mike is aiming for the back ramp. And Pangolin backs into Nemo's Nemesis, tries to force him out of the way. Nemo bumps back. Another hit from Pangolin. Now it looks like they got past each other. And here goes Pangolin!
He's got a clear path of it. Nemo's Nemesis pushed every obstacle out of the way with that wide front. Pangolin is already back to the starting point.
And he is up the ramp, and here goes the last! Pangolin has hugely faced that monster plow, Nemo's Nemesis. And you can see Nemo still struggling in the background there. Pangolin takes out another pay. Nice! Nemo's Nemesis still not driving straight. Kicks a block aside, but can't catch up. Pangolin's got half the platform cleared.
But even if Nemo's Nemesis can get around the track, I don't see how he's going to get up that ramp. I'm not sure if Andy's robot will fit.
Pangolin takes out two more pains. He got three to go. Nemo's Nemesis desperate to score some points here. He's through some rubble and at the third turn. Pangolin takes out two more pains. One to go. And he's got it. There comes the bonus pain. Mike Atkins lines up the shot.
Nemo's Nemesis was so wide, not even a paint can could slip past him. But Pangolin anticipated the problem and skirted his opponent in the only place he could. From there, Gunk was his for the taking.
And Pangolin makes the gauntlet look easy. The scores are Pangolin with 60 over Nemo's Nemesis with 50.